Good day students, in this video lecture we will be seeing the candidate generation procedures which will be used in the frequent item set generation for a priori algorithm. So the candidate generation generates new k candidate item sets based on the frequent k minus 1 candidate item sets found in the previous iteration. So let us now see what are the requirements for an effective candidate generation procedure. First thing is it should avoid generating too many unnecessary candidates. A candidate item set is unnecessary if at least one of its subset is infrequent. So this thing we have already seen while we have seen regarding the anti-monotone property of the support. So if one of the subset is infrequent, then we can consider that particular candidate item set is unnecessary. So we should avoid generating the unnecessary candidate item sets. That is the first thing. Second one is the candidate generation procedure must ensure that candidate set is complete, that it is not going to leave out or it is not going to exclude any of the frequent item sets. It should consider all the frequent item sets in the set, and it should not generate the same candidate item set again and again, that is, it should not duplicate the candidate item set. So these three are the requirements for an effective candidate generation procedure. Now let us go into different candidate generation procedures. Three procedures are given over here, that is brute force method, fk minus 1 into f1 method, fk minus 1 into fk minus 1 method. This particular candidate generation procedures are very important from the exam point of view also. This question has been asked in previous years, and it is very much relevant for the frequent item set generation in the a priori algorithm also. So we will go one by one. So let us see what do you mean by brute force method. As the name says, brute force method means it is a very trivial approach where we try one by one everything, and it takes a lot of time for the computation. But brute force method, what it will do means it will consider every kth item set as a potential candidate, then applies the candidate pruning step to remove any unnecessary candidates. What it will do means at every kth level it will go on generating the candidate item sets, then which is infrequent, that is being pruned. So what is the total number of candidate item sets generated at level k? It will be equal to dck, that is d is the total number of items, k is the number of items we are considering at the kth level. Suppose if I am having the 6 as the total number of items, I may consider 2 items for the 2 candidate item sets. At that time it will be 6c2. If I consider 3 items for the 3 candidate item set generation, then it will be 6c3. Similarly, it will be 6c4 for the 4 candidate item set. Similarly, 6c5 for the 5 candidate item set generation. But the problem over here is the candidate pruning becomes extremely expensive because of the large number of item sets must be examined. So let us see an example over here. So we are given here the 6 items, and we are going to generate the 3 candidate item sets. That will be 3 candidate item sets are generated over here. Then we have to apply the pruning for this to see which one is the frequent. See, our objective in the candidate item set generation or candidate generation remains the same. That is, we want the candidates which are frequent, and we are not in requirement of the infrequent candidates. So once we enumerate all the candidates, that is the three candidate item sets, we should see that frequent one must be selected. For that again the pruning has to be applied, which is expensive in terms of computation. So given the amount of computation needed for each candidate, that is big O of k, the overall complexity of this method will be summation of k is equal to 1 to d, because we have to consider all the k things, into dck, that is the combination of these, which is equivalent to big O of d into 2 to the power of d minus 1. So this is regarding the brute force approach, which is not frequently used, but as a method we can just study it. Next we will go to the f of k minus 1 into f1 method. So this is an alternative method for candidate generation, where the k minus 1 item set is combined with the other frequent items. So we can consider like frequent 2 item set such as beer diapers can be augmented with the frequent item such as bread to produce a candidate 3 item set. So 2 item set is the k minus 1th item set. This is the f1, that is the 1th item set. So these two are combined to produce a candidate 3 item set. So let us see it with an example. So if you see here, we are having the k minus 1th item set being combined with the 1th item set. So what we can do means beer diapers here can be combined with the bread, and we can generate beer diapers bread. So this is an alternative method where f of or f k minus 1th item set is combined with the f1th item set. So this method will produce big O of f of k minus 1 into f of 1 candidate k item sets. But the problem with this approach is it does not satisfy the third requirement of candidate generation procedure. It will generate the duplicate candidate item sets. Suppose if we see here, bread, diapers, milk, this is the three candidate item set. This can be generated by merging bread, diapers with milk, bread, diapers with milk, or it can be generated by merging bread, milk with diapers, or diapers, milk with bread. But all this merging will lead to the same three candidate item set, that is the bread, diapers, milk. So it is going to generate the duplicates, which is not required for us in the candidate generation procedure. So we have to find a workaround for this, or a way out to avoid this. So one way to do that is by ensuring that the items in each frequent item set are kept sorted in their lexicographic or alphabetic order. So if we keep our frequent item set arranged in the alphabetic order or lexicographic order, then we can combine the each frequent k minus 1th item set with the frequent item sets that are lexicographically larger than the items in X. Let us see this with an example. Suppose we are having the item set bread diapers, then it can be augmented with the one candidate item set milk only. The reason is M comes after D, or M comes after B and D, that is it is lexicographically greater or alphabetically greater than the bread and diapers. That's why we can combine. But we cannot combine diapers milk with the bread. The reason is B is not alphabetically greater than D and M. Similarly, bread and milk cannot be combined with the D. The reason is D is alphabetically less than M. In this way, we can avoid the sorry, in this way we can avoid the duplication of the item set being generated. This procedure definitely brings a substantial improvement over the brute force method, but there are high chances that it generates a large number of unnecessary candidates. So the candidates item set obtained by merging beer diapers with milk is unnecessary. The reason is beer and milk is already infrequent. There is no point in you combining and generating beer milk, beer diapers milk, but still it is being generated. That's why we say that there are high chances of generating the unnecessary candidates. There are many heuristic methods available to avoid this unnecessary candidates, but let us not dwell into those heuristic methods. Let us go to the last candidate generation procedure, that is F of or FK minus 1 into FK minus 1 method. The method name itself tells us that here we are going to combine a K minus 1th item set with another K minus 1th item set. So what we are going to do means we are going to merge a pair of frequent K minus 1 item sets only if their first K minus 2 items are identical. This will be clear when we see an example. So if two K minus 1 item sets are there, then its K minus 2 item sets must be identical. If those are identical, then only we can merge and obtain the frequent item set. So let us see what is that. So let A is equal to A1, A2 up to A K minus 1, and B is equal to B1, B2, B3 up to B K minus 1 be a pair of frequent K minus 1 item sets. A and B are merged if they satisfy the following conditions. What is that condition? AI should be equal to BI for I is equal to 1, 2 up to K minus 2, and A of K minus 1 should not be equal to B of K minus 1. That means K up to K minus 2 items must be identical. If they are identical, then we can go ahead with the merging procedure. So let us see this with an example. So frequent item sets bread diapers and bread milk are merged to form a candidate 3 item set bread diapers milk. The reason is here bread and bread are matching, then we can merge bread diapers milk, bread diapers with bread and milk. So if you see over here, we cannot merge bread diapers with beer diapers. The reason is here bread is not equivalent to beer, that is the K minus 2 item, they are not equivalent, so you can't combine that. Suppose if you take, as I have said earlier, that is the bread diapers and bread milk, then you can combine. The reason is both the K minus 2 items are equivalent or same. So as you see over here, algorithm does not have to merge the beer diapers and diapers milk. The reason over here is because the first item is in both item sets is different. So indeed, if the beer diapers milk is a viable candidate, it would have been obtained by merging the beer diapers with the beer milk, because both, if this would have been a viable candidate or actually frequent candidate, then we would have obtained by combining these two, but this has not happened. This FK minus 1 into FK minus 1 method illustrates both the completeness of the candidate generation procedure and advantages of using the lexicographic ordering to prevent the duplicate candidates. Both the requirements are satisfied, or all three requirements are satisfied in this method. So this brings us to an end of lecture regarding the candidate generation procedures. Thank you.